Whoa, look at all those pieces. That's pretty cool, but there's something that's even cooler, something that you've never seen before. An invisibility cloak. This cloak is so cool. Now I can take ice cream from the freezer, make objects float, and walk through walls. Ow! What you just saw was an illusion using a little bit of movie magic. But today, I'm gonna show you an illusion that doesn't use any movie magic at all. Are you ready? Then let's get scienced. Where'd it go? The illusion that I'm going to show you is called the Ames Window. It's an optical illusion, which means it plays a trick on your eyes. I've got one here, and I'm going to start the illusion by spinning it. Make sure you stay to the end of this video because I'll show you how to make one and tell you how it works. As it starts to spin around, can you notice it doing something strange? Whoa, check that out. The window looks like it spins in one direction, stops, and then spins in the other direction. But if we look at it from above, we know that it spins in only one direction. What? That is so cool. And the coolest thing is you can make one yourself to see it in real life. To make one, you'll need the Ames Window template. I've put a link for it in the description below, some thick white card, a permanent marker, a colored marker, a ruler, a pen and pencil, some scissors, and an adult to help you. Start by copying the template to the white card. You can either trace it, or you can press a pen into each corner and then join these dots with a pencil and ruler. Cut around the outside of your card with your scissors. Then turn your card over and trace out the same pattern on the back. Now that you've traced it out, color these shapes with a permanent marker. Once you finish one side, flip it over and color in the same shapes on the other side. This next bit is tricky. You need to cut out these smaller shapes. You can use the scissors if you want, but I got an adult to do it for me. Thanks, Beck. Next, go over the lines and edges with a black marker and ruler. And there it is, your very own optical illusion. Poke two holes through the top corners and tie a piece of cotton thread to each one. You can either hold these ends together or blue tack them to the roof. Spin the window a heap of times and then let go to start the illusion. So how does it work? The closer an object comes to us, the bigger it gets. This minifig is tiny all the way back here, but gigantic when it's really close. Pew, 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 pew. Our brain tells us that if an object looks bigger than a similar object, then it must be closer. The Ames window is a funny shape. It's a trapezoid. One side is longer than the other. When the longer end is closer to you, it looks larger, and so your brain tells you that it's closer. But when the shorter end is closer to you, the longer end still looks larger, and so your brain tells you that that end is still closer. No matter where the long end goes, your brain tells you that it's always closer to you. The only way your brain can make sense of that is to tell you that the window is moving back and forth rather than in a complete circle. There's one more thing that you can do with this window, and it will really impress your friends. Take a piece of Lego with two minifigs on it and use some blue tack to attach it to this part of the window. Start it spinning and see what happens. Awesome! It looks like Luke is moving through the window frame. Maybe that's what I should have tried to walk through those walls. What could have gone wrong? Thanks for watching my video. I hope you have a heap of fun making your own window, and I'll see you again in 2 weeks.